internal strength that you can conjure up in your mind. It's a relationship that you have with your God. God wants us to get stronger. Someone shout stronger.
Stronger.
Says thou, therefore, my son, be strong in the grace. All of the graces of God, joy, peace, kindness, meekness. It's hard to be meek when people treat you a certain way, but you gotta be strong in meekness. Things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others also. Thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Talk to us, Jesus.
Yes.
Help us to endure.
Yes.
The word endure means to continue to exist in the same state or condition. Yes. That means when you were once strong, you got to stay strong. When you were once saved, you got to stay saved.
Yeah.
To endure means to continue in whatever state God has placed you. If you're a worshiper, I don't care how bad it gets, you got to keep worshiping.
Yes. Yes.
If you're a giver and your money dries up, whatever little bit you have, you got to still give. You got to endure. You got to continue. No matter what the affliction, no matter how hard it gets, no matter what it looks like, you got to stay in the same place that God has placed you, steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Endure hardness as a good soldier. I believe that's the reason why the Lord put that in there, because good soldiers don't quit. When you go to war and you're in the army, you're not going to leave out and go somewhere and leave your comrades in the hole by themselves. Enemies coming, you're going to take off running away. The enemy's fighting people and fighting their minds, and you're going to just throw in the towel. Good soldiers don't give up. Good soldiers don't quit. Good soldiers endure. Someone say endure. He's not saying just endure the good times. He says endure hardness. We have to expect hardness to come against us. Jesus said, in this world, you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I've overcome the world.
Amen. Amen.
We must expect tribulation. Cannot be surprised when things come against us. Can't act like somehow the Lord don't know what's going on. God said to let you know, trouble's coming.
Yes.
I thank God for his word. Peter said, arm yourself.
Yes.
Yeah, arm yourself. Because Jesus went through affliction and went through persecution. Arm yourself with the same mind, because you're going to get affliction and you're going to get persecution also. Right now, it's just deception. But the result of deception is releasing the enemy into our atmosphere, into the United States. There's a lot of persecution. I thank God for his word.
Yes.
And the word says, greater is he.
Greater.
I don't care how bad the devil think he is. Greater is he that's in me.
Yes.
Greater is he that's in you.
Yes.
God is greater in you than the devil is in the world.
Yes.
Romans tells us, if God be for us.
Uh-huh. Come on, Bishop.
Trying to help us gird up the loins of our mind and recognize that no matter what the devil tries to throw at us, if God be for us. He goes on to express to us, listen, we're more than conquerors. Come on, stir yourself up. Greater is he that's in you. You're more than a conqueror. Let the Lord be on your side. You have the power to endure hardship. You have the ability. You have the anointing to continue in the fight. Why is God sending the word this way? Because I believe that people are just getting discouraged. Because they're getting weary. Oh, it's the same old thing, same old thing, same old thing. Yeah, it is the same old thing. Because you're doing the same old thing. But trust me, if you get out in the fight, you'll find out it ain't the same old thing. There's different demons out there now. The demon's out there now, so perverse, it scares me. You got to be careful before you become gay. Hello. And also somebody be like, yeah, I ain't knowing, you better shut up. Start messing with the devil too much. We're fighting in a warfare where the devil takes no prisoners. And the world is not able to stand against this kind of enemy. Never seen anything like it. Never seen this kind of, you know, crazy thinking. Where people literally believe children that says, I was a boy, but now I'm a girl. And a parent that's 40 years old says, okay. I mean, there has to be something wrong with the person's mind. It's almost like we've become lunatics. Back in the day, you know, somebody said that, you would say, you're crazy.
Yes.
But now if you say you're crazy, they persecute you and sue you and put you in jail. On every hand, got Christians believing in climate change. Let me tell you, the climate has not changed since the earth began. There's not one scientist that has proved that the climate has changed not even one millimeter of temperature. They get fake scientists to say, if we think it's going to change in the next 50 years, you'll be dead. How will you know? But then all the real scientists that have done the research over the course of the last thousands of years says the temperature has not changed, not one iota. Yet they got church people and people all over the world going, we believe in climate change. And when you say you don't, you're a climate denier. Oh, you're going to jail. Because you won't believe truth. They want you to be crazy like they are. Well, I'm still preaching. We need to wake up and recognize where we're living. And what we're up against, and the people that we have a responsibility to, people that are losing their mind, that don't know truth. God has given you truth. You know the difference between truth and error, and you have to go forth and declare the gospel with boldness. You got to stir yourself up, and you got to let people know, I'm not ashamed of the gospel. It's the power of God unto salvation.
My Lord Jesus.
The devil trying to trick us into thinking what we're doing is not working. Trust me, it is working. If one soul gets saved, the angels in heaven rejoice. I don't care if we ain't got about 50 people in here. Trust me, thousands of people have come through and gotten saved and got the Holy Ghost, got baptized in Jesus' name, and walking with the Lord. Whether they stay here or not, God has used us to do great exploits. Many people have been healed of cancer, high blood pressure, asthma, all kinds of diseases. The power of God is resident right here. I will not give be ashamed of what God is doing because souls are being saved. It's diabolical to try to covet the people of God and make people stay somewhere when God's trying to send them somewhere else. And it's diabolical to think that God is not doing something and so you're going to run off to go somewhere else where God really isn't doing nothing. But God has sent His word to tell you to continue in the fight wherever you are. Fight. People are paying attention to you. They're watching your life. Live it. Walk it. Talk it. Fight. I see people going down in Jesus' name. I see souls from all over the globe going down in Jesus' name. I see all nationalities coming in this place going down in Jesus' name. I see people being baptized, people getting the Holy Ghost speaking in tongues. I see kids getting the Holy Ghost speaking in tongues. I see a vision from the Lord that this thing is not over yet. God is not through yet. There's revival on the way. God is stirring people up. People are hungry for the truth. People are looking for a place where the power of God is resident. People are looking for a people that's not ashamed of the Lord. The people are looking for someone that can help them come out of darkness because the devil is ruthless. He's fierce and he's destroying lives. But I come to declare to you, this is the place that God has established in the web. This is the place where souls can come in and be saved. Lives can be changed. People can be delivered, healed, set free. Someone shout it out. I sense the warfare.
Yes.
I sense it. I see people afraid to say Jesus. I come to tell you, don't be afraid. Fight. Arm yourself. Be ready. It's coming. The people on your job are going to ask you a simple question. Do you believe in gay marriage? And your job is going to be on the line. Because when you say, I believe in heterosexual marriage, they're going to get so angry. They're going to make you take some kind of training. So you can, you know, be more sensitive to the lie. But you understand. I know what I'm talking about. I sense the warfare. It's revving up. And God said to tell you to stay in the fight. The fight is different. But you got to stay in the fight. It's not physical. It's spiritual. Don't be afraid at night. Pray. Don't be afraid to walk the streets. Pray. Don't be afraid to do what God's called you to do. Pray. If he says go to the hospital, don't, I'm going to get sick. You ain't going to get sick. You have the blood of Jesus on you. Just go to the hospital. Lay hands on folks. You ain't going to get sick. You ain't got to be doing all the, every time you go in and out. All that stuff. Don't do nothing anyway. It's all a trick in your mind. They never had nobody washing their hands for thousands of years praying for people in the hospital. Ain't nobody get sick. And all of a sudden, you got to go in and out. You know, you can't go in the bathroom. You got to do this. You know what? Creating fear. I know that people work in the hospital, and I ain't mad at you. Keep on. Understand, you're protecting yourself. I'm trying to make a point that God wants us to stay in the fight. Young people, young adults, old folks, you're not too old to fight. You gotta stay in it. Let's get a little hand praise for you.